Welcome to our H Academy channel. Today we will learn about circles. So what is a circle? Circle is collection of all the points in a plane which are at a constant distance, that is radius, from a fixed point center. That means all the points on a circle are at a fixed distance from the center of the circle. Now look at the diagram. There is no common point between PQ and circle. Hence, PQ is also called as non-intersecting line. In second case, PQ intersects the circle. Hence, there are two common points, A and B. Hence, PQ is called as secant of the circle. In third scenario, PQ touches the circle. Hence, there is only one common point between line and circle. In this case, PQ is a tangent and there is only one common point. The point A is called as point of contact. Common point of a circle and the line is called as point of contact. Remember this. I have drawn multiple lines from point A. Now this line intersects the circle at two points. Now this line also intersects the circle at two points. This line intersects the circle at two points. There's only one line that touches the circle. Hence, we can conclude that there is only one tangent at the point of a circle. Hence, one tangent at one point of the circle. Since we know about the circles and the tangent, let's look at the theorem 10.1. Theorem 10.1 says the tangent at any point of the circle is perpendicular to the radius through the point of contact. That means radius of a circle is perpendicular to the tangent of the circle. As we have learned about circles, the tangent and theorem 10.1, we are ready to solve exercise 10.1. So let's dive in. Question 1 says, how many tangents can a circle have? We know there is only one tangent at a point of the circle. And a circle has infinite number of points. A circle has infinite number of tangents. Let's move to the second question. We have to fill the blank. A tangent to a circle intersects it in how many points? And we know there's only one common point between tangent and a circle. Hence, a tangent intersects the circle at only one point. Part 2 says a line intersecting a circle in two points is called a secant, not a tangent, because it only touches the circle. Part 3 says a circle can have how many parallel tangents at most? Parallel tangent means tangents which do not intersect each other. Hence, a circle can have at most only two parallel tangents. These two tangents will never meet. Scenario also, a circle can have at most only two parallel tangents. Fourth part says, the common point of a tangent to a circle is called the point of contact. Hence, point A is also known as point of contact. The A tangent PQ at point P of a circle of radius 5 cm meets a line through center O at point Q so that OQ is 12 cm. We have to find the length of PQ. Theorem 10.1, it says the tangent is perpendicular to the radius of circle. Hence, we can use Pythagoras theorem to find QP. Since OQP is a right angled triangle and we know the hypotenuse and perpendicular, we just need to find the base. In triangle OPQ, according to Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square. Hypotenuse is OQ, that is 12 cm. Base is QP or PQ. Perpendicular is OP, that's 5 cm. 12 square is 144 minus 5 square is 25, which is equal to PQ square. Hence, 144 minus 25 is 119. Hence, PQ square is 119. Q is square root of 119. Length PQ is 119 centimeter. Note it down. And let's move to the last question of exercise 10.1. Question 4 says, draw a circle and two lines parallel to given line such that one is tangent and another a secant to the circle. Hence, we have to draw a tangent and a secant parallel to L. So, let's draw a tangent first. We know there is only one common point. PQ is a tangent and it is parallel to given line, that is L. We have to draw a secant. Remember, a secant intersects the circle. And EF is a secant, PQ is a tangent. All the lines are parallel to each other. And this brings us to an end of exercise 10.1. And do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you.